Hi, it's Raj Budden here on Subrush Radio, 1260am, online at subrushradio.com and Dab Digital Radio. So, only a few days back, I got you Ritvik Danjani here on Subrush Radio to talk about his experience on Nach Baliye and also Pavitra Rishta. Today, I'm the lucky one because I've got the beautiful lady, Yanagi Asha Negi, joining me live here on Drive. Hi, and welcome to Asha Negi. Hi, Asha.
Hi, Raj. That's my pleasure being on the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. And congratulations to you. Of course, this week being the final week of Nach Baliye, this Saturday we're going to see the big finale. Tell us, how does it feel for you?
I can't tell you. I cannot express the feeling, Raj. Frankly speaking, when I joined Nach Baliye, I was like, I won't be able to do it because Ritvik is a very good dancer. And me, of course, being a non-dancer, I was not that good. So I thought, how will I match up to him? And I really wanted to make his dream come true. I really wanted to win Nach Baliye. But I was very nervous. But recently, gradually, things happened. I worked hard, he worked hard, and we could make it to the finale. And now we're just hoping that he'll win the trophy.
I think with the amount of support you've got, I think it will be quite easy for you to win. But then there is competition with Gurmeet and Dabina as well.
Yes, of course.
How does it feel to be competing with them?
It feels great. Like, Gurmeet is a great dancer. Dabina is a very good dancer. She is very strong. She can do so many lifts with Gurmeet. There are many performances in which she's holding Gurmeet and, you know, spinning and all such lifts she does. So it is, I feel very proud being compared to Gurmeet and Dabina. They are very, very strong contenders. So it is a great feeling, of course. And of course, Gurmeet is a very good friend to Ritvik. And it is a great feeling, yes.
Yeah. And of course, Pavitra Rishta as well. That's going great guns for you. How are you juggling the two shows together?
I don't know that. I swear I don't know that. That was my only issue when I started doing Nach Baliye. I thought that how will I, like, I cannot handle stress, frankly. So I thought, how will I handle two shows, like shooting plus rehearsing for the other show, and that too when I'm not good in dancing, you know. I will take a lot of time in rehearsals and all. So that was my one issue, but you know, things happen. The Pavitra Rishta people, they also managed our shooting schedules, and we managed sometimes with our rehearsals, and we used to shoot in the daytime, and at night we used to rehearse for our act. So things happened. It was a little difficult though because of the shoot also, but we managed it.
That's brilliant. Okay, so Asha, what we're going to do is there's some questions here from fans from worldwide, in fact, and also in the UK as well. So we're going to go to some of those questions. Let's keep the answer short because there's so many questions for you because you've got so many fans. Uza Rehman wants to know first, are you and Ritvik going to be doing any other show after Pavitra Rishta ends?
See, after this, I cannot say that. Like, I don't know if this thing happens. It is, we can only say that after Pavitra Rishta, after Nach Baliye, we have to wait and, you know, hope for the best what happens. Yes, of course, if something great is you know, offered to us, I don't know about Ritvik. I am always ready for it. And, so we're just going to wait and hope for the best. Let's see what comes our way.
There's Uza also asking another question about your relationship with Ritvik. And she wants to know, how does he make you feel? I mean, what does he do that makes you feel so special?
Raj, it's not just once or twice that he does something which makes you feel special. I think it's every moment of the day that he makes me feel special. He makes me feel wanted and needed. And I think he pampers me a lot. And he has spoiled me completely because of that. I have become a very pampered girlfriend. And he's very caring. So I think that's what makes me feel the most special.
Priyanka Das wants to know, what change has Pavitra Rishta brought to your life?
To Priyanka, I would want to tell her that, you know, whatever I am today, whatever I'm doing today, and the love I'm getting from you all is only because of Pavitra Rishta. But I was nothing before Pavitra Rishta, frankly. And after I got Pavitra Rishta, I have been loved by you all. And you all, everybody knows that, how much they love me, Arjun, Purvi, both of us. So I think whatever I am today, every single thing, every single credit, I would like to give it to Pavitra Rishta.
Yusra also wants to know about Pavitra Rishta. She's saying, what do you most like about Purvi's character?
What do I like most? I think Puri is a very simple girl. She's very down to earth, very simple, and I think that's the best thing about her. And why do I like it? Because I think somewhere or the other, Asha Negi is also also like her. I can admit that I'm a very, very simple, very down to earth. I am not praising myself, but yes, of course I know, because I like living a simple life, and that's how I am. I am very simple in my personal life.
Oh, Lamia wants to know, would you ever try your hand in Bollywood?
Bollywood? Currently, no, but definitely, I'm not very keen in doing that, but yes, of course, if in future I am offered a good character, a good role, good movie, then I would like to go for it.
Lamia also wants to ask, with Shiva Chavla, Tasha Joy from USA, I want to ask you, if you're offered a Bollywood film, with whom would you star with, Ritvik or John Abraham?
Okay. Well, definitely it is a very difficult question. John Abraham being my most favorite actor, and Ritvik is of course my partner. But frankly speaking, if I am offered something like that, I would definitely go for Ritvik. That because people already love our chemistry, and they all love the both of us, so there are no chances that our film goes flop. I think the first try, I would love to do it with Ritvik.
Lamia wants to know again, okay, which Jodi on Nach Baliye did you become good friends with beside Rakesh and Riddhi?
Are good friends with us?
Yeah.
Okay, I think Gurmeet is already a very good friend of Ritvik, and they are very sweet people. But apart from them, I think I really like and adore Shivangi. She's a very sweet girl, very simple, very sweet. So she's very much like me, frankly. So I think that is one reason I really like Shivangi. And Ripu is also a very nice guy. So I think Ripu and Shivangi.
Another question here. What is the one compliment that you have never given to Ritvik and you would like to?
One compliment would be, I think I always tell him that he's very caring, he's very sweet, he's very cute, but I've never told him that he's very hot. So I think that's one compliment I would like to give him, yeah.
But I'm sure with you being with him, I'm sure he knows that's also a reason, because obviously he's got to be good looking with a good looking lady like you.
Aw, that's so sweet. Thank you.
Ruchita wants to know, where do you like going on dates with Ritvik? Which kind of maybe restaurants or places in India that you like going with?
Whenever we are free from shoot, you want to know, in Mumbai?
Yeah, in Mumbai, yeah.
Okay. Whenever we are free from shoot and we have a time to lunch together or dinner together, then, there are these Rajasthani thalis. I know that sounds very unromantic, but there are these Rajasthani thalis over here, Marwari thalis, in which you have lots and lots of food, lots of variety. So I think we both like eating that. So that's one place. We always like to go.
Yeah, but Asha, that's what we love about you—the fact that you're so simple, that you're a girl next door kind of person. So that's what I think all of us love about you so much.
Thank you so much, Raj.
Andrea wants to know, how was your experience as Puruvi, and who do you prefer more, Puruvi, Arjun, or Deshmukh?
I think definitely Puruvi Arjun Trilokskar, because Puruvi has always loved Arjun. And I think that's what she always wants to be, Puri Arjun Kirloskar, because she's always loved Arjun and she always wants to be with him. Though she's been compromising herself for her sister and mother and father, I don't know who all. But yes, definitely, Puri would always love to be Puri Arjun Kirloskar.
Okay. Sumaya Ray Chand wants to know, what's your favorite act been in Nach Baliye? What's your favorite act?
Favorite act, I think so far I have loved my act in which I played Helen, because that was completely me. I love doing such wild as in such fast dance. So and I loved the costume which I wore, and the best part was that I was complimented by all the three judges. They were praising me so much, and I think that was my favorite act of my study.
Okay, Lily wants to know, okay, what's the one thing that surprised you most about yourself in Nachbaliye?
I think my growth. Like, I never thought that I would grow so much. I would improve so much in dancing, and I can be so graceful. And I think that is one and only thing that I am surprised about in Nachbaliye. Oh my God, I have improved tremendously. How can I improve so much? I never thought I can do so much.
Hajra wants to know, what's it like working with Ritvik 24/7?
It is great, though we fight a lot because we are always around each other. We fight a lot, but it is always great because I don't know what is going to happen after Nachbaliye. We're not going to be together 24/7. Then how are we going to tackle that? But it is a very nice feeling being with him always, and because he's a very caring person. So and very. He has pampered me a lot throughout the journey of Nachbaliye also. So yeah, I feel like a pampered girlfriend, pampered queen, you can say. So. It has been a very, very nice journey. Wonderful.
Mariam and Lily both want to know, which other TV actors would you like to work with beside Ritvik?
Ram Kapoor again. Though I have worked with him before, but any day, any time, I would love to work with Ram Kapoor. He being such a great actor, and it's a different feeling working with Ram Kapoor. It's a different aura. So Ram Kapoor.
Okay. Serena Desai wants to know, okay, which Karan would you like to work with? Karan Thakur, Karan Wahi, or Karan Singh Grover?
I think Karan Wahi, of course, because he's a great friend, and he's a gem, you can say. Like, we being friends with him, he is a very good friend, a very true friend, you can say. And he's, of course, a very good actor, very good host, very talented host. And so, yeah, that's the reasons I want to work with Karan Wahi.
Okay, Rabab wants to know, okay, name something you want to do that you haven't been able to up until now.
I think there are a lot of things. I haven't yet been to Goa because of my shooting schedules in busy life. So, and it's been almost 2.5 years me in Mumbai. So, and anybody who hears that I haven't been to Goa yet is almost shocked that they always get, oh my God, you haven't been to Goa. So, I would really want to go to Goa as soon as possible, as soon as I get time. So yes, that's one dream goal, you can say.
Asha, in fact, talking about going away and holidays, you're going to go to Dubai, aren't you, for Valentine's, isn't it? You got work?
Yes, we are going to Dubai for Valentine's Day, you can say, but otherwise we are going there for a walk, yeah. Which is, I think, it's been organized by the great, great people. Uh-huh. So the great magazine, you know.
Uh-huh. Oh, so you're going to be... How long are you going to be there for? Are you going to be there for a few days?
Yes, of course. We are going to be there for a few more days. Since it is Ritvik's hometown, you can say. Mm-hmm. And so he'll be... Like, we both will be chilling around with his friends. And I'm going to do shopping, a lot of shopping.
Okay. talking about Dubai, there's someone who's asking questions from Dubai. His name's Ayman, and he wants to know, which is your favorite mobile app? Is it Twitter?
Okay, I think yes, Twitter, because Twitter is one mobile app which connects me with all my fans, all my fans, you can say, of course. They are my friends too, because I keep on chatting with them, keep on talking to them. So yes, of course, Twitter is my favorite app.
Ayman also wants you to rate Ritvik's body out of 10. How much would you rate it?
I would give it an 8, though it's not in shape currently.
Really?
But yet I wouldn't be that rude. 8 out of 10.
Oh man, especially with all the training and all the dancing, I'm sure it is in shape, isn't it?
It is not at its best, I would say.
Acha.
Because I have seen his him in a better body before.
Tika.
So yes, I would give it an 8.
Okay, and Ayman also wants to know, okay, share one prank you have played on Ritvik but you never told him about.
Okay, I'll tell you, this is long back when me and the other girl Ovi from our show, we three were shooting, me, Ritvik and Ovi, Shruti Ganwal. So we were, I think, we were having something, dosa, chutney and all. So the chutney was lying on the thing, on the bed. And Opi and Ritwik, they were having a fight, like a, you know, a fun fight. So Opi was beating him, and suddenly Ritwik sits on the chutney. And his whole pan from back, there was all chutney all over his, back. And he didn't know that. So me and Obi, we both were like, you know, wherever he was going, he was showing everyone, oh my God, look at his back. And he didn't know that. So I think that was one prank which I think I haven't yet shared.
Oh,
I'm sorry if I've already shared it.
Oh, yeah. Luckily, I don't think he's going to find out anytime unless one of the fans let him knows that. But that's quite a good prank. Other question here, Asha, is who is more of a foodie, you or Ritwik?
Okay, more foodie. Huh. I think it's me, of course. Everybody, that I don't have to tell that. I love food. And I cannot compromise on food just for becoming lean or something. But Ritwik can. Ritwik sometimes follows a very strict diet.
And
of course, I am a foodie.
Okay, another question here. So apparently, in one interview, you said that you cry when Ritwik gets angry during rehearsals on Nach Baliye. Is that true?
Yes. Oh, yes, that's true. He shouted on me right during rehearsals.
Oh.
well, you know, that's the part of the show, because me, of course, I am very lazy. Everybody knows that. And sometimes, you know, the stress is so much that he has to do that so that I can get back to my practice and rehearsals, because sometimes I get so lazy, I get so tired after shoot. He scolded me, and that's true. But that's okay.
Oh dear.
I want to win the trophy.
Oh.
As far as I win the trophy, I'm okay with it.
It'd be worth it, Anna. Flory wants to know, what do you enjoy most, acting or dancing?
I think acting any, because that is my first love, you can say. Because dancing, of course, I like, but there is a lot of stress I have felt. A lot of stress and, you know, a lot of hard work in dancing. So, of course, I love dancing. I loved my whole journey in Nach Baliye. I enjoyed it. Especially even after a very good performance, I used to get compliments saying that, Asha, you have improved so much. Oh my God, we didn't expect and all that. So, of course, I love dancing, but I think acting would come first.
Fardina wants to know, describe each judge in one word.
Describe each judge in one word. I think Shilpa Shetty, I would say beautiful. I wanted to say extremely beautiful, but just one word. Okay, and Terence is, I would say, for Terence, very sweet.
Sweet,
sweet. And Sajid? Sorry?
And Sajid?
Sajid, I would say, how do I say that in one word? He is always, he doesn't keep anything in his heart. Whatever he wants to say, he says it to everyone. How do I say that in one word? That's what I mean.
Oh, it's okay. So would you say he's outspoken?
Outspoken, yes. I'm so sorry, I didn't get the word. Outspoken. He's very outspoken.
And honest, isn't it? Though honest here, because he doesn't hold back. He doesn't hold back. He wants to say whatever is on his chest, he will say.
Yeah, he's very honest. He's very outspoken. Yeah, that's what I mean.
Okay, chalo. Next question here is from Manu, saying, what was your parents' first reaction when you told you're in love?
Okay. I'll tell you. This is when I went for a two-day trip to my hometown, and they, of course, knew that we both are very good friends. But, you know, I didn't know, like, me being from a very middle-class family, I didn't know, like, how should I tell them? I was so shy. It was such an embarrassing thing for me. I told my mom, dad, I was like, Papa, Mama, I'm taking part in Nach Baliye, and you guys must be knowing, like, couples come there. He was a little confused. He wanted to ask that. Okay, he even asked me, so Nach Baliye couples come, no? So, you both, what is the exact thing? Like, you'll get to know. I completely ignored them, and I was like, couldn't tell them, you know, everything frankly and clearly, because I was so shy. So I told them half thing and half I left for the. Uh-huh. So now, of course, after watching Najbali, after seeing all the proposal moments and all, they of course know that we both love each other a lot. Yeah.
Neha wants to know, okay, what are the main ingredients in a successful relationship?
What is the main ingredient? I think for the both of us, it is our friendship. Because even if we fight, even if we, you know, we fight a lot. Trust me. Even if we do that a lot, even if we fight a lot, and but still the friendship we both share, and the friendship and the musty, the fun we both do, I think that makes us makes our relationship very special, and that's what brings us back together. So I think, yes, of course, the friendship which we both share is the main ingredient in our relationship.
Mm-hmm. Sidra wants to know, I think a lot of people want to know, when are you planning on getting married?
Oh, there is a lot of time in that, because currently we both are not ready. I think we both are too young for that. So I think there are still at least 3 years from now.
And KSG and Surbi want to know, how have you ever cooked for Ritvik? Are you a person that likes cooking?
Oh, yes, of course I have. I think twice or thrice, but I think the first time it was when he came from an event from abroad, and that was when our relationship just started, and I missed badly, and he too. We both missed each other badly, so I wanted to give him something special, do something special for him. So I was Indian meal, I wore a suit and made bindi for him, bindi and chapatis and a cold coffee. Because bindi is his favorite, lady finger. Bindi is his favorite dish, okay. So I cooked bindi for him, yeah.
That is, so what do you like cooking? I mean, so what do you like making for yourself? What do you like eating?
I am very lazy, Raj. I don't like doing anything. I love when people, you know, make something, cook something for me and I eat. That's what I like.
Jasia says, I love you. Is there anything you would like to change about Ritvik?
No, actually, nothing. I really don't like his habit of not cutting nails. He doesn't cut his nails. I have to tell him thrice, and I don't know how many times, but please cut your nails. But that's okay. I'm there to tell him, to remind him every time, so that's fine.
Kaveri wants to know, what is the best gift that Ritvik has given to you?
Acha, a present, okay. From him, what I want from him, you want to know that.
Which is the best gift that he's already given to you? What is the best one that he's given?
He would give it to me, okay. I think, I don't know. Going for a date to some island and having a candlelight dinner there, I think that would be one present from him.
That is so sweet. There's a question here from Vasvi Sharma. She wants to know, how's your relationship with Karan Wahi?
Oh, it is great. I don't think I have to tell it to everyone, because everybody knows it. They've been watching it on Najbali. It is great. And he's like my, he's like his another wife, Ritvik's another wife. Me and everybody knows that they both have a very good friendship, and they both have very, very good friends with Ritvik and Karan. And I think I was not that great a friend with him before Najbali, but we've been doing Najbali. Even Karan and me have become very good friends, and he's a very nice person. He's a very sweet, very genuine person, and I like fighting with him too. So it is great, yes.
Ryan Kaif wants to know, okay, because you're a celebrity, does that prevent you doing certain things in the public? Because obviously there's always cameras around you.
See, sometimes it's, of course, when, you know, a place is a little crowded, and especially this happens at beaches. I love going to beach, and I love being there, spending time there, but I... usually in Mumbai, especially, the beaches are so crowded that, you know, sometimes I really wish I could go there, but I cannot, because, you know, I sometimes I feel like, you know, I want to spend time alone or with my friends, with Ritvik. Just want to sit and chill. So sometimes I really want to do that, but I cannot.
Yeah
that's one thing which I cannot do always, being a celebrity.
Yeah, Priya Shad and Birdie, they both want to know, would you consider hosting a TV show?
I wouldn't mind, though. I don't know. Like, since before Najbali, I didn't know that I could dance. You know, I could match up with Ritwik and I could improve in dance. So I think the same way. I'm not yet sure. But yes, of course, if I'm offered something like that in the future, I would definitely go for it. Give it a try.
Shruti Deshmukh wants to know, what's your relationship with your old school friends? Do you still keep in touch with them?
Oh, yes, of course. I am in touch with many, many old school friends, especially one is my best friend from school. We've been friends since 8th or 9th, 9th class, 8th class or 9th class, I guess. And through Facebook also, I am in touch with a lot of school friends. And yeah, and though I don't mind going back to my hometown, but whenever I go, I try, you know, taking out time and meeting them.
Ranjina wants to know, okay, what would you like to say to all the Ashvikans for their unconditional love and the support that they've given you?
Okay, now that is something which I think I cannot describe it in words, because all the Ashvikans, I never expected that, you know, they will be giving us so much love, so much support, especially, you know, during Najbali when we need it. We knew that we've got a lot of fans and they love us so much, but it was when we started doing Najbali, when we actually saw that, oh my God, they are so crazy for us and so are we for you all. Mm-hmm. So I think our love for all the Ashvikans, we cannot describe it in words. And we are so thankful. We feel so blessed for having all these people in our life. And I don't know how to thank them. But yes, of course, thank you so much, guys, from Ritwik and Asha, for so much love and so much support. Yeah.
Asha, there's a few shout-outs here. First of all, Crystal wants to say, can you tell Asha that I really, really love her a lot? And she's the cutest girl on earth. And when she's coming to Dubai, I'm going to go and meet her. So there you go. She got some love from Crystal.
Ah, that's so sweet. Thank you so much.
Ruji is saying a big hi from Yuruj. I just like to say good luck for Najbali. You both deserve to win.
Thank you so much. Thank you. That's so sweet.
There's Malia as well. Malia saying, please can you say to Asha that I love you from the bottom of my heart. You and Ritz are the best couple ever. Hugs and kisses to you both.
Thank you so much.
There's a couple more. Anisha wants to say, I only want to say one thing, that her smile is very pretty. Please pass this message on to her.
Thank you, Anisha. Thank you so much.
I think we all love your smile.
Yes, that's so sweet. Thank you.
Imogen wants to say, we love Ashvik. We cannot live without Ashvik. Please make another show together. Please.
That's so sweet. I just hope for the best. Let's see what happens.
Myra wants to say, please just say hi from me and tell her that I love her and Ritwik and I always vote for them on Najbali.
Thank you. Thank you so much, dear.
There's a couple more. Azmia saying, I like to say good luck for Najbali finals and all our love to you. Always, Azmia.
Thank you, Azmia.
And Ruksa is saying, can you ask Asha to shout out our names, please? They are Arena, Habiba, Zainab, Rashi, and it's Ruksar. If you just say hi to them, I think that'll be fine.
Hi, dear. How are you? Thank you so much.
And there's also Priyasha. Priyasha saying, hello, Asha. Priyasha here. Hope you still remember me. We used to chat a lot on Twitter, but now you don't seem to reply. But it's okay. Just want to say all the best for Najbali. You and Ritwik rock. Ritwik is a dancer, but you made me speechless. And now you are a fab dancer. Better dancer than Ritwik now. Way to go, Asha. Lots of love to you.
You know what? I remember. This is Priyasha Govardhan. I'm really sorry, Priyasha, for not replying. It's just that I'm a little busy and, you know, replying everyone on Twitter, all my fans, it becomes a little difficult sometimes. So I'm really sorry. It's not that I'm ignoring you. I love you all. Thank you so much, Priyasha.
Asha, before you go, there's also a quick fire round. In fact, Sana and Grusha, who are massive fans of you, the two sisters, Sana and Grusha, they want to send so much PR to you and they've sent me some rapid fire questions for you. Is this okay?
Oh sure. Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, so first of all, whom would you choose from these, Ritwik or Chocolate?
I think I have replied this to someone. It's Ritwik with Chocolate.
Ritwik with Chocolate.
Yes.
Biryani or Chocolate?
Sorry,
Biryani or Chocolate?
Anytime. I think biryani. Yes.
Okay. And your favorite color?
My favorite colors, are blue and pink.
Blue and pink. Who's more talented, you or Ritvik?
Who's more what?
Talented.
Challenging.
Talented.
Talented, me or Ritvik?
Yeah.
Of course, without any doubt, Ritvik.
Yeah.
I tell you, my IQ is very low. I'm an introvert, he's an extrovert, and he's a very social person. Like, whenever we go to parties, and he's always, you know, around people, talking to everyone. But I'm always the shy one, standing in a corner, till the time I get my friend.
Oh.
Yeah.
And another one here, rank in order of your bonding with these female actors. Gia Mustafa, Shruti Kanwar, Ankita Lokhande, and also Mirlani Tyagi.
Rank in order for?
In terms of your bonding with them.
I'm sorry, I didn't get you.
Who do you bond with most with these of all these four?
I'm so sorry, Raj. Can you please repeat?
Yeah, sure.
I'm standing at the balcony.
It's okay. Who do you bond with most? Which actresses from these do you bond with? Who do you relate with?
Do I bond with more? I think it has to be Shruti Kanwar. We bond so well. We just bond so well. I can't tell you.
Okay, and then second on the list maybe?
You gave me the options of Gia Mustafa, Ankita Lokhande, Shruti Kanwar and?
Ankita, Mirlani, Tyagi?
Achha, Mirlani, Ankita. I think secondly it has to, because I am very close to Gia and Shruti. So, but also like it's not that I'm not close to Ankita Lokhande, she's a sweetheart. But you know, in Pravati Rishta I have Gia Mustafa and Shruti Kanwar as my friends. So it has to be Shruti Kanwar and Gia Mustafa.
Okay. And rank in order of bonding with these male actors. Shakti Arora, Karan Wahi, Karan Sharma and Ankit Narang.
I think Ankit Narang would be the first one because we both are very close. Second would be Karan Sharma since he's from Dehradun and I'm from Dehradun and we both are very old friends. Third would be Karan Wahi and fourth would be Shakti.
Okay. And finally, fans want to hear you in your iconic childish voice. Can you say something to your fans in your childish voice?
Okay, that's how I speak. I don't know, sometimes, you know, me being the youngest one from my family and always being pampered, like now I'm Ritvik's girlfriend and he's also, you know, always pampering me. So I don't know, sometimes I start speaking in that tone, I don't know, but that comes naturally, I don't know. Like, I won't be able to make it up and, you know, talk in that voice. It comes naturally. So, I just hope that in this interview, I would have spoken something in that voice.
But you know, we love you the way you are, Asha. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Raj.
Asha,
thank you so much.
Asha, before you go, we gave an opportunity to one of your fans to come here to talk to you. They just want to say hi to you for a couple of minutes. They're calling from America.
Of course. No, that's okay. In fact, it's very sweet of you, Raj, that you've given me all the messages from my fans one by one. So that's really sweet of you. Thank you so much.
No, Asha, it's been fantastic. And we love you so much. Obviously, your work
is
brilliant.
Thank you, Raj. Thank you so much.
Right, okay. Vishali? Hi, Vishali, it's Raj and also Asha here. Can you hear us?
Hello.
Hi, Asha.
Hi, is that Vishali Maheshwari?
Yes, I'm Vishali.
Hi, Vishali.
I'm so happy.
My pleasure, sweetheart. I know it's Vishali Maheshwari. Now, finally, we are talking.
Yeah, seriously. I just have a few minutes to talk to you.
Yes, Vishali, please tell me.
Yeah. So, I'll speak about you on behalf of all Ashvik fans, and then you can give your reply. Yeah. So, Asha, we love you so much. Our love and respect for you is so much that, like, there are no words that can describe it well. And you are amazing. One of the sweetest persons we have come across in our life. Seriously.
Thank you so much. You know what, guys? It's you who have made us. It's you who have, you know, make us reach here. We've reached here only because of you guys. And we sometimes get some, you know, very emotional sitting whenever we are like sitting alone and you guys just sing, oh my God, these people love us so much. We don't have words, how do we thank you guys?
We love you because you have that something in you which makes us
feel
loved.
That's so sweet of you.
We love you guys even
so much more. We would have been nowhere. where you guys wouldn't have supported, wouldn't have loved us so much. Thank you so much, yeah. Really love my Charlie.
And your
thank you.
Your journey like has been spectacular. You are no less than a professional.
Thanks, Priya. It's only because of you guys. I'm sure at this credit, I would also want to give you all. It's only because of you guys I have improved so much. You guys had the faith on me, and you guys knew that I could do it. And see, I have done it.
Vaishali, yes. Vaishali, thank you so much for your time. There you go. You got your opportunity to speak to Asha Negi here on Subrash Radio. Vaishali, look after yourself.
Thank you so much, Raj. Thank you, Asha. It was nice.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Vaishali.
Thank you. It was nice talking to you.
Thank you, Vaishali.
Thank you so much. I just hope
it's that we win. Asha, thank you so much for your time. It has been a pleasure.
Thank you, Raj.
No, thank you very much.
Raj.
And wish you all the best
thank
for this
so
weekend.
Much.
All right. Take care. Speak to you soon.
Thank you, Raj. It was great talking to you.
Thank
bye-bye.
You. Bye.
Bye. See you. Bye-bye.